Put it in
the shade. PJ, thank you. Another round of applause for PJ. Nishiwa, Inisai, Miyonji Inai. Which means, hello and welcome, and I'm not Japanese, okay? I'm not even Asian. Well, let me tell you all my grandparents were born in Mexico. My father was born in Mexico, and my mother was born in El Paso. Yeah, okay, Mexico. So I'm not Asian, I'm a good driver. Sorry, Nelson. I am an engineer, and I'm good at math. I taught math, so maybe I have some Asian in me. And I love engineering, especially digital engineering, because it's a binary world. Ones and zeros, high, lows, yes or no. So all my jokes might be binary. They're either funny or they're not. You know what I mean? And I'm waiting for California to legalize marijuana because I'm working on a new GPS. It's called the GPS 420. I've done the hardware, I've done the software, I'm working on the recording. So one of them sounds like this. In the next 1,000 feet, turn right on Elm Street, continue north and proceed to... Oh, look, a Taco Bell! Rerouting. I did teach math, and I tell you, so this really happened. I was teaching fractions, 7th grade. God, we were that bad in 7th grade. I can't believe it. But teaching fractions, and the kid said, "Oh, Mr. Foskis, why do we have no fractions? You got no fractions. I don't care if you're a baker, if you're a truck driver, if you're an engineer, but we're not going to be an engineer. It doesn't matter." And then, of course, there's always one guy in the class, right? Memo. He says, "I'm going to be a drug dealer." All right. I should have left it alone, but I said, "Okay, you're a drug dealer, right? You're going to make a deal, and the seller's going to sell you 2/7 of an ounce for $100, or 4/9 of an ounce for $80. And you gotta make the best deal, because if you don't, the boss is going to whack you. So what is it, Memo?" And all the children, their eyes grew big, and then they started learning fractions. So I won that battle. Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah. But then, years later, a few months ago, I woke up in the middle of the night thinking, "What have I done? This guy probably is now the head accountant for the cartel, thanks to me. I just can't win." So I'm really happy to be in comedy and singing, because I am celebrating 8 years of being cancer-free.
Thank you.
We got it. We went through radiation and chemo, and we got it. So thank you. I think you might be even happier for me when I tell you that not only am I cancer-free, not only am I a cancer survivor, I'm also an ex-wife survivor. Thank you. Well, okay, not so much. The cancer we got, the ex-wife, she's going to be around for a while. We tried chemo, we tried radiation, drive-bys. That's not going to work. She's going to be around. That's okay, we're getting along. I got 2 daughters, and my ex-wife, my daughters, we're like this. This is me. They don't like me. So I'm dating now. I'm single. Oh, thank you for that moment of indifference.
Yeah.
And it's not easy dating. No. I tried a lot of things. I dated a lawyer. That got expensive. Cost me $500 every time I called her. I did a police officer at LAPD. Oh, man, she was tough. No snacks. First time we had sex, she gave me a ticket. For speeding.
I thought you're parked illegally.
Yeah, of course, I T-boned her. I went out with schizophrenic. I considered it a double date. We had fun, so we went out for quite a few months, all three of us. First time we had sex, when I was a twin. But I know now, after dating all those women, and sometimes it's just my own fault, you know, because I have some standards, and I've met some women on the internet, and some of the women, they either talk too much, You don't talk enough, but you can't go sign on a loan. And I need that co-sign. And what else? And I did actually meet someone that I thought was going somewhere. Sally was her name. And we exchanged pictures. We talked on the phone. She liked me. I liked her. And she wanted to move the relationship forward. So she said, Julian, why don't I come over and we can do some adult things? I said, okay. So you want to come over and help me balance my checkbook and do the wash and mow the lawn? Okay. Like that. I was hoping that you would want to come over and we could do some teenage things. I call my parents up and ask them for money. What else? Let's see. Oh, I don't have to work anymore. Right? So, but I still want to apply for jobs because I want to go on those interviews and answer those, honestly, answer those stupid questions. Like, where do you see yourself in 5 years? Not here. And also, what's the other one? What is it you hate most about work? Work. And the other thing is, what conflict have you had in your job, and how did you solve it? Well, I had a female boss, and she was making sexual advances, and I said, I don't do that during working hours. So the way I solved that, I said, meet me in my car at lunch. I'll take care of it. And I was respected. Okay, that's my time. Thank you very much.